might be anyone, a lone fool out in the sun. Your heartbeat of solid gold, I love you, you'll never know. When the daylight comes, you feel so cold. You know I'm too afraid of my heart to let you go. Waiting for the fire to light, feeling like we could do right. Be the one that makes tonight, 'cause freedom is a lonely road.
So we've made it. Oh, that's going back in. We're at Dovecote. Finally. Nice, it's a little bit weedy. The rods are out. So yeah. See what occurs. Warm, proper warm it is. But yeah, it's looking nice. So I've got three spots out. So there's one out towards the island, sort of here. It's only at 10 and a quarter, so it's nowhere near that. Obviously, just fishing at holes in the weed. And there's another one again at 10 and a quarter, just off the left of the pylon. And then there's one I just took down the margin just down here, which is sort of there. It's like six and a quarter. But yeah, it's proper weedy. I think that's been the case for most of the places this year, isn't it? And a lot of the lakes, but the weed is pretty to the surface, new fishing holes in it. But here's what it is. So I'm on braid. So swans have been a bit of a pain in the ass today. Coming in thinking you're gonna feed them when you're not. But yeah. We'll see how it goes. Here for the next 48, so off like 10, 11 o'clock Saturday morning, my time will be up. So not expecting anything probably till this evening, or probably tonight to be fair, because I had a bit of disturbance. I suppose that's the only small downfall with the 48 hour rule, which I still do agree with, is that the first half of the first day, you're basically crashing and bashing about in you. And you could probably just do that extra 12 hours tagged on, but here's what it is. And we'll see what's going on, but they're out earlier in the boat clearing snags and I don't know, line and rubbish. And they saw quite a few fish out in front of me. Some decent fish as well, they said. So I'm in the area on EVG baits and particle stuff. Ooh, that wind's picking up. Pole guys tackle, turn and tackle, so that's going to help me to drag one of these fellas in. Well, play it in. We'll see how it goes. Well, the dog's retired for the evening. Rods are out. Well, excuse the nice covering for me waders. And we're fishing. And right hand rod, I've had a liner. I saw it, obviously just plinked off a fish moving through the weed, but yeah, here's what it is. It's calmed down a bit now. I've got, I thought fishing on here might be a bit different, but it is a club ticket, so I've got spotty and no eye ears next to me. So my left hand, well, my middle rod in effect, which is sort of in line, slightly to the left of that pylon, you can see. they were leading across earlier. I mean, looking at it, they're about 25, 35 yards down the bank from me, but you just have to deal with it, don't you? They've finally given up now, spotting all over the place. I wouldn't even mind, but their spotting wasn't even accurate. Not that I'm, you know, king of the spots, but at least I make sure that they hit the spot and hit the right accuracy every time. But they're all over the shop, but yeah, I suppose that's what to expect, innit? That's probably why I'm going to spend more time down here in the autumn and in the winter to spring, when a lot of the fair weather fellows politely have retired for the year and don't come out until the sun's again. But yeah, anyway, looks promising. First session, don't really expect a lot. It's a bit of a information gathering session, really. I'd had a walk around today, had a look in each swim. The fact that this one was free, it was near the road, a bit lazy, although I brought the barrow. I didn't need to barrow stuff. I could just in effect walk it through the gate and I was there. I think it's definitely obviously a known swim, and I found a couple of spots pretty quickly in the weed. They're like pretty rock hard, so I'm fishing them. Whether that's a good idea or not, I don't know. Sometimes it's best to go against the grain and try and find different spots, but I did have a fish like literally off the rod tips here come and swirl earlier on, so not far off that marker there, which is my wading marker, to say don't go too much further than that, Chris, because you're only short and you'll get a wader full of water. But yeah, anyway, we'll see how it goes. We're out, we're fishing. You never know, there's a 50 or two and some maybe 40s wandering around out there in the weed. Hopefully they come my way, but yeah, we'll see. Spotty's at it again. It's like half past 8. He's had no action. He thinks it's still a good idea to start hoofing out bait. All to be fishing next to two nods. Not that I'm a fucking fantastic angler myself, but Jesus Christ. There we go, a different spot now, look. No fucking accuracy. Chucking chance it. 10-acre lake. Only two on here now. Well, three. There was two of them. And he has to go 25, 35 years to my left. And then earlier on decides to start leading across the middle rod, straight out in front of me. And look, it's just like, you know, what a donor. Like me, bring on the autumn and the winter. Yeah, I'll get some proper fishing done on here. Because it's as bad as linear. That's harsh. This is a lovely place. Proper nice place, but yeah, unfortunate. Oh, is there another one coming out? God knows how much bait he's brought with him. I dare not go down. He's probably got one of them bloody wheelie bins or something. Thinking it's a good idea to. Oh no, I think he might have given up. Oh no, no, no. Yeah, don't know what happened there. Anyway, well, I've had another couple of fish sightings on my spots, or my right hand spot anyway, which is far enough away from spotty and no ears. So yeah, fingers crossed I don't disturb it too much. They're fizzing. That's there. Another one about there. There was another fish, but then there. So close. I don't know. My final morning, just running the clock out in 48 hours, although I'll probably leave a bit earlier than I can. Just waiting for the sun to come up and dry the bivvy out. It's a bit damp. Cooler night last night, a bit of wind. Thought I might have had something, but nothing. But they're really active this morning. I've seen at least 11 different fish in this area. There, thereabouts, across all three rods, fizzing. They're obviously on some sort of natural or something on the bottom, but at least the baits are down there, so you never know. But I think it's going to be a blank. Would have been nice to have had one, but to be honest, it's more of a reccie trip than anything else. I'll probably concentrate on this in the autumn. Yeah, we'll see what happens, but yeah. If I have a fish, I'll obviously show you, but I don't think that's going to be a possibility. Although, seeing these fish fizzing about this morning just makes me wish I could have had an extra 12 hours, because I think that might have helped me. But anyway, it is what it is, and we'll be back soon.